It's Squirrel Girl, and I'm going to be reviewing my two newest comic books. What even is that voice? Why would I do that? Just kidding, it's just me, Presley. But I have a Squirrel Girl cosplay that we've actually almost completed. And I decided that I'd wear it because both of the comic books that I'm reviewing have Squirrel Girl in them. And so honestly, let's start with the Unbeatable Squirrel Girl one. Two. It's their second number one of this year. So honestly, I thought they were stopping Squirrel Girl and just continuing with the New Avengers since she's in those. But actually, she gets her rerun of a comic book. So she actually has another series going, which I'm really, really excited about because I love seeing just Squirrel Girl, like, playing around. Well, like, just Squirrel Girl and her character, cast of characters. But this actually does have a lot of references to the New Avengers, because since she is part of the New Avengers. So they're not doing the thing where they just, like, kind of catch up with the current comic books. Like, there's a comic book series that you have to wait to catch up with the current comic books. But actually, it's kind of going on at the same time as this one. Well, not the same time, but somewhat around the same time. So she talks about how she's part of the New Avengers, and she has this teleporter to Avengers Island, so she can go there whenever she wants to with the teleporter that's in her closet. That's apparently very loud. But this is a really great issue, and she seems to have, in some of the parts in this issue, she has a little bit of a new outfit, but on the cover, looks like she's kind of wearing the same outfit that I'm wearing right now. But she has a new outfit through most of this comic book. I don't know if she's staying with that outfit or if she's gonna go back to the outfit that I'm wearing in the next few issues. But yes, I'm very, very excited to have new Squirrel Girls. And yet again, there's still comments at the bottom of the page. And it's just, so let's start talking a little bit about what's going on. So Squirrel Girl and Nancy are moving in with each other in a new apartment. And Nancy has actually dyed her hair red, which looks really, really nice. And it's kind of nice seeing, like, in this book, like, changes to the characters that were from the last series. So, like, Nancy has red hair, and she's wearing a different outfit, but I'm not sure about the outfit staying. And Nancy's probably gonna have, like, red hair for most of the series. But yes, really, really good. So there's actually a little bit of foreshadowing in this one that Nancy might actually be able to talk to animals, and those animals are cats. So there's a little bit of foreshadowing there because Squirrel Girl has Tippy Toe, and then she has a cat named Mew, and it could be possible foreshadowing that she will be able to talk to cats. And there's also a little bits of Squirrel Girl's backstory incorporated really, really well because Squirrel Girl is taking Nancy to meet her parents. Well, it's just her mom because her dad wasn't able to make it. But she goes there and there's little bits of Squirrel Girl's backstory told in embarrassing stories that your parents tell. So it's really, really, really good and actually really funny, but you're still learning about her backstory. And apparently her mom's pregnancy was a very, very eventful. So her dad's name is Dor. And her mom's name is Maureen, and Squirrel Girl's name is Doreen. So it's like a combination of the two. And she actually talks about it like, well, we couldn't come up with a new name, so we just squashed our names together. And the comment on that is also very hilarious. But yeah, it's just so good to have new Squirrel Girl content. And she also fights this half-robot, half-human guy who's a brain and eyeballs, who threatens to eat Tippy Toe and Mew. Even though he doesn't have a mouth, or a digestive tract, or teeth. So that was kind of a very, very empty threat. But it's really actually really cool that she's in computer science. So she can use her computer science skills to kind of work with the robot person. And it's really, really good. So let's move on to the New Avengers, which continues the plot with, I can't even remember the title of the shape. They look like Plum Bobs from Sims, so I'm gonna call them Plum Bobs, with the Plum Bob-headed people. And as always, Squirrel Girl's in it, and there's all sorts of people that are banded together to form the New Avengers. So they're still in Paris trying to fix this issue, And actually what's really interesting is what they did is they actually took a couple of the characters and gave them the Flumbop heads. And, like, that helped them solve it in the end because they have these, like, connections to all the members of the New Avengers. So they could find out what was going on and how they were transforming. And it actually turns out it's, like, this sound frequency. So if they played the opposite frequency and could cancel out that sound frequency and everyone went back to normal in Paris. And Tibito also got a little Plumbob head, which is really, really adorable. And actually, his is an actual, like, Plumbob shape. Like, it's a diamond. While everyone else's is the kind of Plumbob. I need the other book so I can actually see what these are called. But yeah, it's really, really interesting. And it's actually just like a little bit scientific, like where they're talking about how they're talking about how the people got the Plumbob heads and how like to counter that and like the sound frequency stuff. Which is actually really, really good. And they do it a tiny bit in Squirrel Girl 2, since she's computer science and she's working with, like, this robot. So they're doing stuff there, too. So both of these are really, really really good, and they both have Squirrel Girl in them. I highly recommend both of them. So yeah, thank you for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye!